Yo, what's going on, everyone? Today, I had a bit of an epiphany of thoughts and feelings about a certain topic, and I thought no other better to have the man, the mystery, the legend himself, Tekken 101.
Hey, James, thanks for having me. Talking some Bleach today. This should be fun.
Yeah, I know. Getting a One Piece YouTube. I'm joking. Kido, what are your thoughts, bro?
Oh, my God. So you mentioned this a couple days ago, like, you know, like, how would you do, like, Kido? Like, is it possible to be, like, a Kido master without, like, a Zanpakuto? Like, to be a powerful Shinigami without a Zanpakuto, we're relying more on Kido and like how Kido is like underutilized. And I'm like, oh god, yes, of course it is. Because you have this whole magic system in Bleach, and there's another one that's similar in Burn the Witch as well, which maybe we could talk about that a little bit. But the idea is, yeah, there are these all these really powerful spells. There's a Kido core and stuff in the Soul Society, and we never really focus on that as much as I would have liked. So I'm really excited to talk about this today.
It's one of actually my main criticisms with Bleach, actually. It's because it's like you can have so many utilized battles. And I like that with like Shuhei, for example, where he's using it against like someone like Findor in the Karakura Town war arc. And Soifon using binding spells as she's trying to sting other Rankar and whatnot. So it is definitely, especially Urahara. We don't need to talk about Urahara. But yeah, he is one that has definitely mastered through thick and thin many different types. And that's always interesting as well.
It's really malleable too, because the thing with Uehara, and it's like, not to talk about him, but you know, talking about him,
we could all die, you know.
Him and a lot of other like Mayuri and stuff, they kind of like develop their own Kido. So it's sort of this whole idea of like there's like raw stuff, I guess it's just the Ryatsu of everything, and then you could kind of have the set Kido that are, I guess, taught in like the academy or in like the Kido core, but then you can like make your own unique Kido, and Hachi does a bunch of that.
It's almost like it's like your personal identity, I guess you could say, like,
yeah.
You've made your own.
I would say it's not as versatile as like Nen from like Hunter x Hunter, if you've ever seen that.
Sure,
like,
that's
like my favorite power system in all of anime, because you can like do anything you want with it. It's not that versatile, but like you could do some really crazy stuff with Kido. Like you talked about earlier before we started this, the whole thing with the two forbidding spells that Tessai uses in Turn Back the Pendulum. It's spatial freeze, just stopping time in an area and then teleporting wherever you need to go.
Exactly. It's a really big minefield with it, because you can go so many different directions with it, which Kubo could have really utilized really well with it. But I don't want to get into the bread and butter of that, because like I think we need to really build up to this, you know, that is broken, and we'll explain why.
Yeah,
first and foremost, what are your thoughts on the idea of Kido being used without an incantation or even saying its name? I mean, we see this very early in Bleach, where, you know, Ichigo is going up against a Menace Grande, and Urahara stops Rukia with a click of his finger and kind of binds her. And I always felt like that was like the difference between, because obviously she was weak because she was in a Giga and whatnot. If he had said an incantation or a spell at that moment, maybe it would have crushed her soul or even damaged her
to some degree.
So that's why maybe he did that. What do you think on the limitation with that? Do you think that that is only based on like lower level Kido spells, or do you think it can go into the higher ranking?
So the way I always interpreted it was that every Kido has an incantation to go with it. And there were two methods that this was utilized. The first, the one that's used a lot, is the incantation abandonment, where they just do the spell. Like Byakuya did this, for instance, against Renji. And Renji even mentioned it. It was such a big deal. Renji was using his Bankai against him, and Byakuya just raises his finger and uses, I think, Sokatsui, number 33. And he summons this giant, like, explosion, and Renji was surprised by that. Not the Rikujokoro. It was like just the lightning shock. And Renji was surprised by that. He was like, wow, he was able to do this much damage without an incantation. So abandoning the incantation will decrease the power of the spell. But if you're strong enough, like a Byakuya or Uehara level character, it kind of doesn't matter anyway. And then the other kind was what Hachi used against Barragan, where you can use the spell without the incantation, but then add it after to strengthen it. So,
there's
like both ways, because he summoned the turtle gate thing in front of Barragan, and then he started to recite the incantation to add more layers to the shield. So I think everyone has an incantation. If you're a lower level Shinigami and you're just learning Kido and you use it without a spell, without an incantation, it can be a very, very weak spell. But when you're strong enough, it kind of doesn't become that much of an issue.
That then obviously goes on to, you know, we saw Ichiba use it against Yuabak. He wasn't even using incantations like that. He was just saying it as its name, which goes to really show.
Yeah, Ichiba was using like hidden spells. He was using probably like forbidden spells similar to what like Tessai was using. He was like hidden hottos and stuff like that. Yeah.
Do you think they're the same at all?
Like the forbidden spells like Tessai?
Yeah.
I think there are. I think there's like black arts or some kind of like forbidden tome of like keto spells that like only the keto core and like the zero squad are like they're aware of, you know, not every Shinigami's gonna
so
be
like,
taught
it's,
this. Yeah.
So it's like forbidden in the Soul Society, but when you get to Soul Palace, it's like anything goes, right?
Yeah, it's kind of like they created everything. Well, the whole idea, the whole concept around the Zero Squad is they each contributed something to the Soul Society. Nimeya created the Zanpakuto, so it's possible that one of them created Kido. Probably Ichibei, because he named everything and the significance with naming to begin with, so...
So before we even touch upon Forbidden Kidos and... Can you, as a sort, and I know we see kind of Nanao do this into some certain degree, you know, but I think even more down to a character that we know quite well of, such as like Unohana, right, with her healing abilities.
Yeah.
Whether that's, I don't think it was with her Bankai, but, you know, she was healing herself almost instantaneously with
Kido. Yeah, the implication I got was that she was healing herself with her, I think it was called Kaido, which is funny because I talk about One Piece, so there's Kaido in One Piece. Kaido is healing Kido.
It's conflicting.
Yeah. But no, I think she was using her healing Kido to heal herself, and then her Zanpakuto in its Bankai was doing something completely different, and it was still...
But it was almost instantaneous, right?
Yeah. It's like, that's how good she was at it, yeah.
Yeah, exactly, right? So, you know, Kido obviously is also leveled by how much spiritual energy you have as well and how potent you are. That's very apparent as well. It kind of got me into the question of like, well, you know, Aizen talks about being like he's transcendent or he's reached the limits of all four styles of fighting for Shinigami, right? And it's like, well, have you, mate? Because when he used Black Coffin on Komamura on Tokyo Kill Hill, he says, oh, that was weaker than I expected it to be. And even using a full incantation against Dangai Ichigo didn't exactly go the way he planned. So clearly, he was a bit arrogant.
You know what?
In
yeah,
his
now that
ability,
I think about
yeah.
that, that does make a lot of, that does kind of contradict Aizen because he just said, like, that same chapter, I've mastered all four combat methods. And then he uses number 90 and he's like, I have a hard time controlling that one. It's like, yeah, well, but if you've mastered it, then, you know.
It's one of those things where he doesn't directly say it, but it's very heavily implied of like, but Shinigami is, you know, can only reach a limit. So the only way to break that limit is holification. It's like, well, okay, why are you doing it then? Are you saying that you've done this without saying that he's done this?
Aizen is so arrogant that, you know, he would be the one that wouldn't admit it outright, but you can like infer it.
But I think that's what's great about his character, because he is the epitome of contradiction,
yeah.
I think. So, but we know how strong Aizen is because of his immense spiritual energy, and it shows that, especially within the Thousand Year Blood War arc as well, saying, oh, well, I'm gonna, you know, just bring down the Soul Palace with my spiritual energy.
The core of, like, everything Shinigami related, and Aizen even said this during Fate Karakura, it all comes down to your Riatsu. It all comes down to how much Riatsu you have.
Absolutely.
If you have more Riatsu, your Kidos are stronger, your Zanpakuto is going to be stronger, you're going to be faster. When Soifone used her, you know, the two hits certain death against Aizen, which everybody, remember back then, everyone was like, Soifone, just do the two hits against Aizen. Kill him immediately. And she finally does it, and then Aizen's like, that won't work, and the reason it won't work is just because I have more Riatsu than you, so there's nothing you can do about it.
Yeah, just absolutely nerfed it by doubling it. So
yeah.
We know that Kido falls under that same suit as well as Zanpakuto, right? It can be negated by the strength of your own ability. So the question is, and the whole point of the discussion is, you know, say Nanao, for example, or just, you know, you get reincarnated as a Soul Reaper and you choose not to have a Zanpakuto, or you choose not to use it. Can you, as a Soul Reaper, be on the same ability as someone like Yamamoto, obviously after like a few hundred years of training, naturally, but do you think you could solely rely on Kido, and do you think it is an underutilized ability?
Yeah, I would say you can. That's something that I wish that Kubo would have expanded upon a little bit more there, just because, like, the Kido core exists. And yes, Hachi and Tessai, ostensibly we think they have Zanpakuto, but they never use them. Like, Tessai had that staff thing. Maybe that was his Zanpakuto, but he never used it, you know? And so if we expanded a little bit more into the Kido core, we would probably see a bunch of Shinigami in the Kido core that were more masters of Kido, obviously, and they might have had Kido-based Zanpakuto, kind of like how Momo's is. But yeah, I think it's totally possible if you could master Kido and you could be on par with a captain if you had all the, you know, not to the utmost levels like Aizen and stuff, but just like, if you get up into the 80s of Kido, maybe like a 90 could be like your Bankai equivalent or something like
that.
They could be pretty damn devastating, absolutely. We even saw when Shunsui was fighting Lilia Vero during last arc, he used a Kido sword. There's a Kido that's like a Kido blade, and it just like, okay, well, there you go. There's
it was your... like a whirlwind, right?
Yeah. It's kind of like, all right, even if you don't have a Zanpakuto, there's Kido that even give you swords kind of made out of Kido. So that's pretty neat. Yeah.
That's what really kind of threw me off when I was thinking about this, because I was like, you have abilities which stop time and teleport, right? Now, Tessai is nowhere near on the skill tree of Yamamoto or even Squad Zero or even Aizen, for example. And I feel like it is such a missed opportunity that we didn't get to see these abilities used in a really broken way in the Thousand Year Blood War arc, because especially when you have Lilaibaro, who is Your light, and he's obviously going against Kyaka at, well, instantaneous speeds.
Yeah.
It's just like, it would be cool to see those abilities used, or would that actually be a problem if they were used
more? I think it would be a problem, and I gotta be honest with you, during the turn back the pendulum when Tessai uses those forbidden Kidos, I kind of immediately felt like, okay, they're not gonna use these again, are they? This is just an excuse so they could just stop time and get everybody back to Uehara's lab. And it's like, you know, the Zero Squad should probably know about these forbidden Kidos. How come Ichibei didn't use them against Yuha? How come Aizen did not know them? You know what I mean? Like, you think he would have figured something out like that. The ability to stop time and freeze space. I mean, to teleport and freeze space
in and of itself.
Yeah,
right? It's crazy.
That itself is insanely overpowered. And I feel like Kubo might have felt like, well, it's so broken, I can't use that again because that's going to be a problem in an actual fight. You know what I mean?
Which I think is probably the case of how Uwatch kind of like took so long to rebirth himself, was probably because of Ichibei's like doing of sealing.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
If you can seal Aizen for 20,000 years, one, who did it? And if it's a collective of Central 46, they must have a good collective amount of spiritual energy to even pull that off to make it last that long.
Yeah.
Because obviously we know through Baragon that you can age like Kido.
Yeah.
But also at the same time, it's like, well, how did you watch one, obviously, not only get defeated, and hopefully the anime can expand on that.
I hope so.
Give us that
flashback. I think they will. I think that this anime is going to, it's really going to fill in a lot of the gaps with the last arc. That's why I'm so pumped for this.
I'm begging so bad, dude. You don't even know. Like, it is something we need.
October, it's coming, James. October, we're going to finally get the answers.
I'm trying to compress myself. I don't need this fanboy right now.
Only took 6 years, but we're finally gonna fight.
We're here. It's been a long journey.
Oh god, but, yeah.
But it would definitely, you know, if we see Ichibei or even Yamamoto pull out a Kido that, you know, manages to seal or even stop time, right? Or teleport him into a space of which, you know, cannot be reached, would really solidify the utility of Kido and how important it is, not only as a defensive, protective, and even offensive measure. And I feel like people really don't give, as you said, with Nen, with Hunter x Hunter, give that mechanic enough love, because it's always like, oh, I can't wait to see so-and-so use Bankai. Well,
also,
I kind of want to see some Kidos, man.
It also doesn't help that whenever we do get Kido, it's almost always the same ones. You know, number 31, Shakaho. Number 33, Sokatsui. Rikujikoro.
Yeah.
Like, those are the ones everybody always
uses. Like,
there's a hundred of them. And also, I think it's implied there's some that share the same number. So it's implied that the number just represents the skill difficulty, not like just one Kido for each number.
Absolutely. And there's different versions.
How did you feel about apparently the strongest one ever, Hado 99, which is the dragon thing that Aizen pulled out in like the second to last chapter? You know, it just kind of seemed like a giant dragon that wrecked the ground a bit and then really didn't do anything else.
It was unfortunate because you didn't really get that context until like the light novels, right? Which
is really
unfortunate. And the ability to engulf surrounding spiritual pressure around you is kind of a broken technique, and I can see why Aizen would use it, because if you watch has got all this, you know, spiritual energy just like fluttering around everywhere. If you want to take some of that away and weaken your opponent, it is extremely useful for people like him, for Uwatch, right? So again, it lives up to its name. Again, it's a shame we didn't get to see it in the manga.
Like a thing in Brave Souls too, you can use it as well. The dragon.
It did. But I think, again, until we have that visual representation and a good explanation of it, rather than a kind of summary, you'll kind of understand how like great this ability is.
It really seemed like something just thrown in it by the end of the battle. Like, you know, it was like, oh, Aizen uses the strongest Kido in the series. Here it is. Like, you don't get to see much of it.
One panel, five.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, and a bunch of rubble too. Sorry.
Yeah, it summons a cool dragon and a bunch of rubble. That's it. I'm like, okay.
Yeah, because I think Kisuke also uses it as well.
Does he? That'd be cool. Yeah, yeah. I can't remember if he does, but that would make sense if he could. Yeah. We got Black Coffin is 90, and then I think the sky cannon thing that Uehara used against Aizen, that was like the really. I actually memorized the incantation of that a long time ago. I can't remember all of it. And then
no, you gotta do it now.
Hold on. It's not that I just like have the keto page.
Googling right now.
Right,
it's like,
here.
Hold on.
Limit of 1,000 hands, respectful hands unable to touch the darkness, shooting hands unable to reflect the blue sky, the road that blasting in light, the wind that ignited the embers and that gathers both together. There is no reason to be hesitant to obey my orders. Light bullets, 8 bodies, night items, book of habits. Where does Kubo come up with half of this shit? Like,
your memory is absolutely immaculate.
It's not that I'm reading this totally off the thing. But yeah, so we have that, and then we have Ito Kaso, which is the giant, that even itself, like that giant blade cremation thing Yamamoto used against Aizen, and it kind of just singed his clothing, and that was all it did.
Which was also something I wanted to bring up to you. Like, do you think Yamamoto was even powerful enough to use that technique?
That's a question in of itself. Like, was that the payment of the keto, like, no matter what you do, or was that just because Yamamoto
was... He was weak.
He was, he was weaker. He was beaten at that point. He was very bloodied at that point. Was that the reason he lost an arm? I don't know.
Yeah, because we don't really see with any other keto, like, a sacrifice. So, again, I wish there was, like, a whole just data book explaining what each and every single keto does.
Oh, my God, that'd be so cool. Well, I was going to bring up Burn the Witch a bit. They brought in spells there. And I like the way that they were utilized there, although I think Kubo came out and said they're not exactly the same thing, but they're like a different system.
It comes from the tools, supposedly, and I went through all those 4 chapters and I looked and I was like trying to find a way where they didn't use a tool for it, but no, it seems like most of them are coming from the tools themselves. And I mean, it's magic, right?
It's
and that's
magic.
What essentially Kido is. Essentially, it is the Soul Society's version of magic. If you want to put them in the same bubble, I wouldn't argue with anyone with it.
Fits, because, like, you know, the Soul Society has a feudalistic Japan theme, and it's like a prayer, kind of, in a little bit, like a little prayer or chant or incantation,
a ritual. Yeah,
yeah. And then the spells that the witches and stuff do in Wingbind,
Harry Potter.
Yeah, it's more Harry Potter. I love the way Bruno does it, where he takes the spray can out and just sprays stuff in the sky, and then like,
oh, dude, that is so
that was so
meta,
cool.
Bro.
Yeah,
that
yeah,
is
yeah.
so cool.
I love Bruno
and the mouth moving on the balaclava too. Like, that's so cool. I think Burn the Witch, like, it has a lot of potential in the future. I mean, as a starting arc, was very strong. I can understand if people aren't on that hype level of Bleach, because obviously we've had to tone it down. But
because I haven't really been paying attention to the news of it. Is it announced that they're going to continue it, or like manga?
And the Witch, yeah, season 2, yeah.
Okay.
Didn't right. happen. It was in the last page of Weekly Shonen Jump, and then Kubo came out and said, hey, I said I'd do it, but not yet.
I feel like Kubo now is just like, it's coming out on my schedule, right? Like, the same thing with, like,
that's
the
great, right?
The 75-page chapter we got last year of Bleach, which was amazing, by the way. It ended on a cliffhanger, but there was no, like, if it's going to be continued. I think Kubo's just like, it's done when I get it done.
Seeing as I've got you here, when you left that chapter, did you feel like that was the end?
No.
Exactly. Right,
like, there were so many cliffhangers they opened up. Like, Uketake's in hell now, apparently. That's a big deal. And they just,
It's great. I think it's great marketing, because it really, like, shows who's still interested in Bleach. And also, at the same time, you got to take into consideration, not only is Kubo doing the fan club stuff, he's also going in and making sure the animation's good, the pre-production's all good for the anime, and as well as then after that he will be doing, like, the merch and the art exposition. So he's really, really been busy, and people are like, I want this next chapter, I want this next chapter. Calm down.
Yeah,
like,
you don't
he will
rush
get
it.
To it
yeah.
when he gets to it. Like, anyways, we'll have another, like, Oda 6 situation or Togashi 6 situation.
No,
you
we
don't
want
that.
Yeah. I've heard that just because in recent years, like, supernatural theme manga, like Jujutsu Kaisen is a good one, they're becoming so much more popular. That's why, like, a reemergence in the interest in Bleach, because Bleach was kind of one of the first ones. Bleach was one of those ones where it's like, you know, main character's a teenager that is, like, can see ghosts and spirits and stuff, and then fights alongside them. I mean, that was something that, you know, that was one of the, Bleach was one of the good ones. Speaking of Ichigo, really quick, here's something that always bugged me about Kido, looping it back. Ichigo is a 15-year-old kid that gets superpowers, and he seems not interested in learning keto at all, and I'm just calling BS on that.
Who, like, wouldn't, right?
Yeah, I mean, who wouldn't want to learn how to fire lightning out of your fingers, you know,
with a finger point too, or just like bind people with a hand swipe? Like, come on,
you're a teenager and you get a magic sword that's huge and that's really awesome, but it's like, hey, I want to learn how to fire fireballs. And he might look, Ichigo he's not like as good at it like Byakuya or Rukia, but he could go to Uketake and like, can you teach me some like first level Kidos, learn some basic kind of stuff? That would be cool.
If anything, it'd be pretty dangerous considering his like immense spiritual energy.
Yeah.
If he was to try it without being taught how to control himself, he could probably do a lot of damage.
That's probably a good reason why they didn't do it. But by the end of the Soul Society, I mean, by the end of the series.
Just train in the Dongai though, right? It's like.
Yeah, but by the end of the series, also after training in the Soul Palace, Ichigo, it's implied he has a much better control over everything now, so I think he could learn it.
Absolutely.
So, yeah.
I mean, whoever wants to risk be his teacher, I guess. Urahara!
Urahara would love that. That'd just be hilarious. Back
to it. As I've said to many different people, I think the Hell Arc is definitely an expansion of different avenues for characters to go through, especially with people like Aizen and people like Ichigo and Kisuke. They're going to have to be thrown into a realm of which they're not used to. And I think we're going to have to see more than just Shikai and Bankai.
It really embodies just, this is the finale it seems Bleach always deserved. It always felt like Hell was kind of an untouched, I mean, aside from the fourth movie, it was kind
that
was mentioned, but this is the perfect way to kind of wrap the ribbon around Bleach and kind of call it like a full series. You know?
Would you want it to go further than Hell?
No. I think one more arc, the Hell arc, whatever you want to call it, and we address things in that realm, and then we kind of move on, and then we just kind of end the series there.
But if I told you that Kubo announced that there is another realm in Bleach, and it is and it is the fairy realm.
Huh. Okay. Well.
Yeah.
So, okay. So a while back, years ago, because this is all based on the realms of Buddhism. I'm sure you understand that. Like,
Yeah, sure.
You got the mortal realm, the Deva realm, which is the realm of the Soul Society. You got Hell, mm-hmm. obviously. The Hungry Ghost realm is obviously Hueco Mundo. A fairy realm.
Yes.
Nah, Kubo, you don't have to go that far with it. You don't have to do the Feywild in Bleach.
He says there's a yokai and fairy realm, though I feel like yokai is like Hell,
right? That's Hell in Hueco Mundo, right. I would say, are yokai.
Right.
If nothing else, if you want to do fairy realm shit, do that with Burn the Witch. Maybe don't do that with Bleach. I think that would actually fit way better with Burn the Witch.
Maybe that's what he was implying, but translations or bad interpretation, I guess that could be. Or I was thinking, hey, this might be something for like a really cool arc for Ichigo and Kazui, maybe, I don't know, but I'm always open to the idea. He's not really ever let me down when it comes to concept, so I'll be open-minded to him.
I would be too, but let's talk about that for a moment. Kazui apparently has the ability to open gates to Hell.
Yeah, what's wrong with that?
Oh, it's just nothing much. I mean, granted, all the crazy abilities that Orihime plus Ichigo, and they had a kid, I guess it would make sense that their kid would have some really wacky powers, you know?
As much as I would like to have an answer for that, I don't. I think my only, I guess, thought about it was, is that there is a ritual to opening up the Senkaimon, right? And he just isn't being taught to, and nobody knows he's even doing it. He's probably just opening up the portal wrong and thus sending spirits to Hell.
That's really dark when you think about it. Like, Kazui's like 5. So Ichigo probably told him a little bit about, like, there's this place called the Soul Society and it's where you go when you die, but I'll tell you about it more when you get older. And then Kazui could just open gates to Hell.
He starts clapping his hands and boom!
Yeah, he's like, this is where you go to the Soul Society. He's like throwing ghosts in there and they're actually being sent to Hell.
Enjoy, this is your life of prosperity. Fuck!
Oh my god, that's so dark.
You hate to see it, but also it's also adorable.
I mean, it is. I mean, I love the fact that Ichigo is just a dad now in the series. I feel like that's the perfect way to really bring his character full circle. Because Ichigo, he's not like Naruto, who were like Naruto wanted to be the Hokage. Ichigo doesn't want to be king of the Soul Society or whatever. He just wanted to be, you know, wanted to protect his friends. That's his main thing. And then just have a family. And then here we go. And then I think that's the perfect way where his character ended up.
And I think the Soul Society also kind of agree with it too and let him do what he needs to do as well, because they trust him. They know he's not going to deceive them in any malicious way. So
Ichigo's like 30 at this point, I think, in the story, or something like that. Late
27.
20s. 27. Wait. Oh god, I'm older than Ichigo still. God. Well, it was he's 12 years. We know numbers. Clearly Ichigo was 17 in the final arc, and then 12 years happened, so clearly we know it's 29.
If you do the maths and get the calculator out, you would actually find out.
So yeah, keto, I would love a data book. I did a video once on my channel. I went through every single keto that was ever talked about in the story. There's so many gaps though, because of the numbers.
I did sit there and watch that, and I was just like, what the fuck? What? I was like, he's doing it. I'm all fair play to him. He's got more balls than me.
God, there's so much to it.
There is, but it's a great topic because it's there's many things in Bleach which are untapped, and keto is one of them. And it just goes to show that even though Bleach is over, there is still more room for play, you know. And I think when we live in a era of anime now where we have lots of reboots and lots of sequels happening, to have something like Dragon Ball, for example, where there is a time skip and there is a gap, and we have Dragon Ball Super now, love it or hate it, you know, people will always watch it and love it because of that nostalgia. And I think, you know, it's good because it leaves open that time gap to have many different stories inside coincide and lead up to that eventual last chapter.
It was so cathartic though when that chapter came out, the extended chapter, and I was able to just, it wasn't numbered, but I just called it chapter 687 because it was so good to talk about Bleach again. So I'm glad it's getting, like, it's coming back. And mm-hmm. all things considered, like, look how long it took for Dragon Ball. Like, the original Dragon Ball Z anime ended in the 90s and Super didn't come out until like 2013, 2014 or whatever.
Absolutely.
And I think even later than that, I think it was like 2015. But, you know, with Bleach, it took like 6 years since the manga ended. And it's just like, yeah, we're going to be finishing this off. So I'm glad it's like coming back sooner rather than later. And we're going to be getting it this year. I think this is going to be a good year for a lot of Bleach.
It's going to be a busy year. That's for sure. It's going to be a very busy year for people like me and you. That's for sure.
I've mentioned this last time. I've been talking about this for like 2 years, but I want to start that podcast this summer. And it's going to call Boncast, which, there you go.
Boncast. There you go.
Not a name I was not clever enough to come up with that. One of my fans did. But so we're going to be doing Boncast. And the plan is to start it in maybe August and talk about, I want to go through every arc in Bleach. It's like a refresher for everybody and have some guests on. Like, I'll have you on, obviously, and like Ace and everybody. Aww. Yeah, of course.
Yes, for
and
me.
We could come on a Boncast and we could talk about the arcs and lead them up. And then when we get to the arc, when we get to Thousand Year Blood War arc, I don't know if I'll do like an episode by episode review, or maybe like once every 2 weeks we'll do a recap, something like that. I have to figure out the schedule for it.
And there you go. He just self-promoted himself. To conclude this video, because I have got to edit it. Thank you so much, Tekin, for your thoughts on keto, and I'm glad you're in the kind of same boat as me in regards to like where we feel about it, right? And it's just a discussion. I wish I could come up with a consensus about this. The same with you as well. Like, it's really up for discussion what you guys in the comment section think about keto, what you liked, what you disliked about it, how you would use it, and how you see Forbidden Keto. Should the time and the teleportation ketos have stayed as a one-time use? Or would you have liked to have seen more of it? Are you more on my side or Tekken's side in that regard?
You get the implication that, like, they were forbidden so they don't mess up the whole thing with the Soul Society. But if you're in, like, the middle of war, like, you know, why didn't these really strong characters use them or something? Like, Uehara should have known or something, you know?
Absolutely, yeah. Right? You know, considering if you did do a full incantation with the freezing time one, could you increase the range? And that's a whole other
bag of worms for another day. Yeah.
Okay, so... thank you so much, Tekin, for joining
me. Yeah, no problem, man. Anytime.
Go subscribe to Tekin in the comment section and the description down below and show him some love in any future uploads that he does. And with that being said, I'm going to catch motherfuckers later. You guys, of course, have this fine day. I've been Hanson, as always, people. Peace out.
Signing out. Later.